regular grooming makes you more familiar with all of the physical attributes of your horse. And regular grooming of your horse is also a great way to build a trusting relationship. Most horses appreciate the extra attention they get while you spend some time grooming them. So today I wanted to share with you a really effective grooming routine for you to make the most of the time that you have with your horse. Hello, my equestrian friends. It's me, Lisa, the budget equestrian. Welcome back to another video. And like I said in the beginning, today I wanted to share with you just basic grooming with your horse and how to really get an effective grooming routine going so that you can make the most of the time that you have with your horse. Grooming is an important component of maintaining a healthy and happy horse. A regular, methodical grooming routine helps your horse's skin to remain healthy. It stimulates his circulation and massages his muscles while distributing the oils of his skin to create a gleaming coat. With regular grooming, you can't help but notice lumps, scrapes, skin irritation, ticks, or even other abnormalities in a timely way. Grooming is also essential prior to tacking up your horse. If his hair is clean underneath your tack, his skin is less likely to become irritated from wearing it. Your horse becomes more comfortable working with you, and of course, another added benefit is that your tack is cleaner at the end of your ride. A fully stocked kit of horse grooming supplies is essential for any rider. Now, to begin your grooming routine with your horse, a really great place to start is with cleaning out his hooves. By tending to the feet first, you can look for problems that may require attention, or it might prevent you from riding that day, such as a loose or a missing shoe. As you run your hand down each leg to lift each hoof, feel for any unusual lumps, scrapes, or heat that may require treatment. And when cleaning your horse's feet, make sure your rear end is pointing toward the front of the horse and your toes are pointing straight toward the back. And after cleaning out his hooves, the next part of your grooming routine is the curry comb and currying. Start at the upper neck and work down towards his tail. Use a curry comb in a circular motion on the fleshiest part of your horse. Currying offers many benefits. It loosens shedding hair and dirt. It stimulates and massages the skin and muscles, and it helps to spread the natural skin oils that protect hair and produce a shine. You can never do enough currying, in my opinion. Curry in circles against the grain of the hair. When you're on the left side of your horse, curry with your right hand. And when you're on the right side of your horse, you guessed it, use your left hand. Avoid currying over bony areas with a hard or inflexible curry comb, and press only as hard as your horse can tolerate. Be careful of ticklish areas such as the flank or belly, because touching these areas can trigger defensive behavior in some sensitive skinned horses. A soft and pliable curry with tiny flexible fingers or a textured rubber mitt may be used gently on the legs and possibly your horse's face depending on how he tolerates it. Some people hold a curry in one hand and a stiff brush in the other to work one patch of hair at a time, currying and then brushing each area out. Others tend to curry one side or the entire horse before using the first body brush. Use whichever method works best for you. Be sure to knock the teeth of your curry against the back of a brush occasionally to get rid of that extra dirt and debris. Many horses have a favorite area or two that they like to have curried. Try to find a special location on your horse. You'll know it when his upper lip starts quivering or he leans hard into the curry to scratch an itch. Now, after you're all done using the curry comb, start by using a stiff bristled body brush. Again, you're going to start at the head and you're going to work towards your horse's tail. Now, if you're lucky enough to have a horse vacuum, you could use the horse vacuum in place of the stiff brush. Or if it's shedding season, you could use a shedding tool on his coat to remove lots of excess hair with each swipe. Now, back to the stiff brush. Use the stiff brush in a quick, flicking-like motion, pushing in the direction of the hair growth and only as hard as your horse will comfortably tolerate. The firmer your brush stroke, the more you'll accomplish. If you're brushing effectively, you'll see a cloud of dust and hair flip from your horse with each brush stroke. Every few strokes, scrape the tip of the brush bristles against a curry or the teeth of a shedding blade to clear away the excess debris. Avoid brushing your horse's most sensitive areas with a stiff brush. like if you have a mare in her udder area or a gelding sheath area, and maybe even your horse's face, depending on his personal preference. Stiff brushes are safe to use on your horse's legs. Just be somewhat gentle. Be sure to brush the back of the pasterns and the points of the hocks to remove dirt that can collect there. The more elbow grease you use in brushing, the more natural shine that you're going to bring to your horse's coat. Now, when brushing your horse's face, it's better to stand slightly to the side rather than directly in front of him, because you want to protect your face just in case your horse suddenly raises his head. If your horse is extremely sensitive or thin-skinned and doesn't like the coarseness of a stiff brush, you can look for a medium brush that still provides enough rigidness to pull dried dirt from his coat, but is slightly softer and more comfortable for his sensitive skin. Now, after using the stiff brush or the horse vacuum, you could move on to either a medium brush or a soft brush. A medium stiff brush is a good next step to take on a really dirty horse between using the stiff and the soft brush. Their bristles are often somewhat closer together than those of a stiff brush, so they can pull another layer of grime from your horse. And if you're lucky enough to have a vacuum, a medium brush is a great next step to use after you've vacuumed your horse. Now, the last brush that we're going to use in our grooming routine is a soft brush. It's very soft, closely spaced bristles that capture the finest particles of dust from your horse's coat and smooth the hair to leave it lying flat and sleek. Use a soft brush in long, smoothing strokes rather than short, flicking actions that you did with the stiffer brushes. And remember to clean the tips of the bristles as you work by scraping the brush either against a curry or a shedding blade. If your horse is ticklish, a soft brush may be the best bet for you. And again, the more elbow grease you use with the soft brush, even on his face, the more natural oil that's going to be distributed to his hair and the shinier your horse will be. You can use your fingers or a wide tooth mane and tail comb to separate the hairs of your horse's mane and tail without breaking them. You can also use a brush on your horse's tail instead of using a mane comb, because that'll help to lay things down without breaking off those hairs. And the finishing step is to use a clean, dampened cloth to wipe any debris carefully from your horse's eyes, nose, and another one to wipe off his rectum and under his tail. This will add a soft sheen in these areas. Some horses appreciate having these areas clean, while others really resent the process. Just be very careful until your horse is accustomed to the procedure. And if you don't have little towels that you can use, baby wipes or wet wipes are an excellent alternative for cleaning out your horse's nose, around his eyes, and underneath his tail. And if you follow these steps of grooming every time you're with your horse, soon it will become a habit, and then it will be an easy part of your everyday horse care routine. Your horse will really appreciate the extra time that you're spending with them, and you'll be rewarded with a gleaming, glowing, and beautiful horse. Thank you so much for taking time out of your day to watch this video. Be sure to subscribe to my channel for lots of other videos showing you how to make the most of the time that you have with your horse. Again, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.